Sawasadee, welcome to Cambodia. Angkor, north of Siem Reap in Cambodia, covers around 400 square kilometers. This UNESCO World Heritage Site includes several temples of Khmer architecture, meaning they were not built for worshippers, but as a palace of the god who was enshrined there. These temples date from around the 9th century and began as Hindu religious sites until sometime in the 12th century when they became Buddhist sites. Angkor Wat, inside the wall, covers about 200 acres, and outside the wall is a strip of land and a 570-foot wide moat still filled with water. Angkor is one of the largest archaeological sites in operation in the world. Tourism is important to the area, as well as ongoing local religious traditions. UNESCO understands the necessity to preserve the special atmosphere of Angkor, knowing they must guarantee physical, spiritual, and emotional accessibility to the site for visitors. The stories told in all the bas-relief and carvings on these structures is unending. Angkor Thom, with the carved faces, dates from the late 12th century, also constructed under Javerman the VII's reign. The south gate, with four faces pointing in each of the cardinal directions, is quite impressive. This is preceded by an avenue of the gods and demons, lining the bridge across the moat. This entrance is similar to the other four gates, but this one is the most extensively restored and most complete. These two rows of figures each carry the body of a giant serpent, a seven-headed naga, almost like a tug of war. Inside Angkor Thom, there are more smiling faces. Of the original 216 faces, 173 have survived. The others collapsed. There are many more carvings and more stories to tell. Thank you. There are transportation options for viewing this area. Some people choose to ride the elephants. There are entertainers along the way and many shopping opportunities. Is probably the most recognized site in Angkor, with all the silk cotton tree and strangler fig tree roots entwined among the ruins. This area was chosen to be left in its natural state as an example of how most of Angkor looked on its discovery in the 19th century. Workers will continue to stabilize the site as necessary, but want to preserve the way it looks now for future generations. Aided by international teams of preservationists, Cambodian architects, engineers, and artisans now struggle against time and thieves to document and restore this ancient core of their identity. There is so much more to see in Cambodia, in addition to the temple sites of Angkor. Daily life in rural Cambodia, small villages, rice fields, palm tree sugar making. And then back in Siem Reap, artisans are at work. There is fine dining, street food, markets of all sorts to walk through and people to watch. Think about having a fish pedicure before you leave.